we all arrived at the port of Miami, spirits were high.
Hi.
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 So glad you could come.
Brought the whole family.
Yeah, huh? We sure did.
Bahoya.
Bahoya.
Mother Nature wasn't much help when it came to a big send-off. But the rain didn't dampen the enthusiasm of the folks at the Ambassador Travel Party.
Hey, baby! What do you know?
Captain Gear Loken took command as we left the channel.
Okay, you all can come on in. The boat's following out the traffic lights.
So we left the lights of Miami and headed out to sea. Our first 2 days on the Norway were spent entirely at sea. And though the ocean was calm, the Saga Theater was rocking. It was the first chance for the fans to meet the stars, who talked about everything from nicknames.
So what's the deal with Bubba?
Well, that's my nickname. That's what people call
nickname?
Me since I was a little guy, yeah.
To the secret of success.
I don't know what it is, but I'm going to try to hold on to it.
To the motion of the ocean.
You know, the more the boat rocks, the better I like it.
And Tanya knows how to make sure the place rocks.
No, it won't be me. To see her fall apart would be more than I could bear. Cause I'm just too close to that girl in the mirror there.
But being a featured entertainer is just one of Tanya's jobs on this cruise. Her parents, Bo and Juanita, are along for the ride. They were married 50 years ago and never had a fancy wedding. So Tanya secretly invited friends and family for a lavish ceremony at sea. Tanya's trying to plan the wedding.
Hang on. Earrings.
And keep it a secret at the same time. Her sister LaCosta is helping with the details.
Let mother wear your diamonds.
Like jewelry.
I didn't bring any diamonds. Right.
Accessories.
You have a hat.
And girl things.
Hope you can't see through this thing. Can you see through it? She's 15.
Like getting married.
And he's barely driving a car. Better rehearse. She's got his ring. Ooh. Oh, don't she look beautiful? Looks like an angel. Well, we're going to a party. I don't know where y'all are going.
Juanita thinks Tanya gave her this dress for a captain's party.
And we're going to gradually walk down and meet the captain and do that whole number. You know, you got to do that all the time. Got to go see the boy running this ship.
Bo waits in the lobby, but when Juanita arrives, he knows something is up. And he's right.
Mommy, we finally decided we'd go get married.
Yeah. We decided you should get married.
Yeah.
Juanita is shocked, and the theater is transformed into a wedding chapel with dozens of family and friends in attendance.
And on the tour day, there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee.
Captain Gear Loken performed the ceremony where vows were repeated.
I promise to continue to respect you.
Rings were exchanged. And a pronouncement was made.
May I present Mr. and Mrs. Bo and Juanita Tucker again. Right on wrong.
Then Tanya sang the song she recorded for her parents.
Like two sparrows in a hurricane.
There were a few family portraits. Then, with baby Bo and daughter Presley in tow, the party began.
I just couldn't believe it.
Presley! Come here, hurry, quick!
Smile.
Woo! Perfect. Look here, Pres.
One more.
Anybody have any lipstick?
Really?
Now you gonna have to feed each other.
Are you gonna get one for me?
And Juanita have dedicated much of their lives to Tanya and her career. Tanya reflected on her feelings the day after the wedding in the spacious owner's suite.
Are you as nervous as the bride was?
Getting anywhere near a wedding gown makes me nervous. But I was a little nervous. I wanted it to come off really, really special for them. And I felt the tears coming, but you know, you're standing there, everybody's watching you. And so I kind of held off on that because I knew my dad was getting very emotional as well. Everybody was, though. Everybody in the audience was crying and all the friends and relatives. So it's a special thing.
Well, now you were outside the theater when they both met for the first time and realized probably
yes,
what was up. But
right.
What was that like for you to watch?
Well, it was just, you could tell. It was just, well, looks like we're going to get married again. But it was really a special moment.
Since you have such great parents and such strong parents, what kind of a mom do you want to be to your kids?
Mm. Well, that's a good one because see how to answer this question. I feel like I have about two more real hard years, hard time, as far as my touring schedule. And I would hope that I can slow down a little bit to where I can take them to school, I can do all the things. I had Presley's birthday party and I had to have someone, you know. I want to do some of those things. And to me, the best thing about way to be a parent is the time you spend with your children. My parents were so good with me. I mean, I don't remember never feeling loved or feeling left out or any of those feelings a lot of children have.
How do you let your children know you love them?
Oh, well. I'm constantly telling them, constantly showing them, constantly. My little girl is my little snuggle buddy. You know, I slept without her last night. And I'm, you know, it's almost scary to love something so much.
This is nice. It seems like you really have strong relationships with a lot of people around you.
Yeah, I like it that way. You know, I've always been one to say, hey, I ain't got 20 years to be best friends. Mm-hmm. Let's do it now, you know. I mean, let's don't wait that long.
Yeah.
Let's get into the good stuff now and just get to the heart of things.
At the reception for your parents the other night, several of their friends were kind of standing
yes.
around talking to us. And one of the gentlemen said, as he was watching you walk around and talk, he said, you know, that girl has the softest heart. He says, you know, she has the reputation for being a Texas
yeah,
tornado.
Yeah, right.
So energetic, but he said she really does have that soft spot and wants to do nice things for people.
Yeah.
Would you agree with that statement?
Oh, I would definitely. I mean, I've never been one to brag on my singing or my looks or anything else, but I definitely will tell you I'm a good-hearted person.
Can you ever imagine yourself being married to someone for 50 years?
No, I really can't.
No.
I really can't imagine in my mind. I mean, I know that it's possible. That's what keeps me hanging in there. But I know it's possible. So certainly hope I can have that in my life, too.
What kind of qualities would the guy have who wanted to spend the rest of his life with Tanya Tucker?
Well, I think he'd probably, I've got it down pretty much to a science now. No, not really, not that good.
Yeah.
He'd have to be adventurous, someone that likes to do things on the spur of the moment. Likes to do nature things, outdoor things, as well as go to the White House and have dinner. You know, we can do all those things. Because my life is so versatile. I have so many things and so many wonderful possibilities. I need someone that I can share those things with.
Mm-hmm.
And I want my own bathroom, though. My own closet. You get really kind of set in your ways, you know. You get to where you like things a certain way. But I'm sure that if I found someone that I loved enough, I'd be willing to change a few of those things.
Well, now you just mentioned to me that you start getting nervous around anybody's wedding dress.
That's right.
Is that a scary thing for you?
Yeah, I think so. I think I was listening to somebody the other day, and they said, I think I'm too spoiled or set in my ways, or maybe I don't know, maybe I don't want to compromise. I'm pretty independent. And it's going to take a heck of a guy to come in and step over all those walls, you know. I mean, he's got a hard road to hoe. Good luck. <Yeah. laughs> But, you know, like I said, it's possible. Mm-hmm. Who knows, there might be someone out there crazy enough to fall in love with me.
Coming up, Clowning with Colin.